We would like to welcome you to Sacred Heart Church as we celebrate the 32nd Sunday in Ordinary Time. The readings begin on page 79. At this Mass, we pray in a special way for the repose of the soul of Frank Fowler. Let us begin by praying our Sacred Heart offering. O Jesus, through the Immaculate Heart of the sufferings of this day, in union with the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass throughout the world, I offer them, for all the intentions of your Sacred Heart, the salvation of souls, the reparation of sins, and the reunion of all Christians. I offer them for peace and justice in the world, the well-being of my loved ones, and the intentions of our Holy Father, the Pope. Amen. Please stand as we begin the Mass and greet our celebrant, Father Mathieu.
And the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done. In what I have failed to do, through my fault, through all. Therefore, our Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our Father. The Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you,
we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father,
Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us.
For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
Let us pray. In this Mass today, we're going to be praying for the repose of the soul of Frank Taylor. Almighty and merciful God, graciously keep from us all adversity, so that unhindered in mind and body alike, we may pursue in freedom of heart
the things that are yours. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. Resplendent and unfading is wisdom, and she is readily perceived by those who love her, and found by those who seek her. She hastens to make herself known in anticipation of their desire. Whoever watches for her at dawn shall not be disappointed, for he shall find her sitting by his gate. For taking thought of wisdom is the perfection of prudence, and whoever for her sake keeps vigil shall quickly be free from care. Because she makes her own rounds, seeking those worthy of her, and graciously appears to them in the ways, and meets them with all solicitude. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with a word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus, we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The foolish ones, when taking their lamps, brought no oil with them, but the wise brought flasks of oil with their lamps. Since the bridegroom was long delayed, they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight, there was a cry, "Behold, the bridegroom, come out to meet him." Then all those virgins got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish one said to the wise, "Give us some of your oils, for our lamps are going out." But the wise ones replied, "No, for there may not be enough for us and you. Go instead to the merchants and buy some for yourselves." While they went off to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went into the wedding feast with him. Then the door was locked. Afterwards, the other virgins came and said, "Lord, Lord, open the door for us." But he said in reply, "Amen, I say to you, I do not know you. Therefore, stay awake, for you know neither the day nor the hour." The Gospel of the Lord.
In this parable, Jesus is the bridegroom who will come again to invite us to go with him. He will not force us. He comes into our lives not only when we die, but also each day through the daily events of our lives. He is constantly reminding us to be prepared. The parable is telling us that the church is a procession of people making their way through life to meet the Lord when he comes. Some keep their lips of vigilance, while others neglect to nourish their faith because of many attractions of our modern world, which are not Christian or life-giving. So, the wise and foolish bridesmaids stand for these two types of Christians: those who hear the word and keep it, and those who hear the word but do not keep it. The Catholic Church always teaches us to be prepared, to equip ourselves with virtues, to be wise, attentive to the future. As Christians, we have to be always on our guard because we don't know the time or the hour the Master will arrive and to get ready to go with him. That is why we insist on the readiness that should be a way of living for each one of us. Readiness includes prudence and acting wisely according to what we are expecting for. The Feast of Christ, the King of the Universe, in 2 weeks, will conclude this liturgical year A and will open right away the year B with the first week of Advent. This circle in our liturgical life is to prepare and to keep us in alert that we should not miss any opportunities to get connected with Jesus. My brothers and sisters, Jesus talks about what it means to be prepared to receive the kingdom of heaven. Jesus wants his disciples to understand that the exact day and time cannot be predicted. He teaches them that they must remain vigilant so that they will not be caught unprepared. In today's gospel, Jesus is teaching us the same attitude that we should adopt if we really want to be counted among his guests entering the kingdom with the bridegroom. The wise virgins in our gospel reading are masters of prudence, remaining under guard throughout their vigil. They have prudently tended their lips and conserved their oil, and so they are ready to receive the bridegroom. For sure, they may have had much to learn along the way, but their prudence and foresight have made them ready. These other virgins had waited alongside with diligence too, awaiting the great moment of arrival at the last hour. Having failed to remember the supply of oil, disaster strikes and all is lost. It is indeed for them a costly mistake. These virgins, described as foolish, might well be worthy of the title through their tardiness. Their lips have patiently chided the darkness and warmed the air as they anticipated the arrival approach. Yet their tardiness results in abandonment. Brothers and sisters, what Jesus is telling us in this parable is, keep your eyes open, for you do not know the day nor the hour when the Lord will come. In other words, we should prepare for his coming in us. Readiness asks us to be prudent, sober, vigilant, watchful, and prepared. That's the way to be in the. It should not be a moment of attendance at Mass, like you are Christians only when you are at church and someone else outside. Being Christians is a choice that we have made freely to be with Jesus wherever we are, and that should be reflected in every aspect of our lives. For the presence of the Lord among us is something we have already, not something for which we need to wait. The truth, there is still time before the fullness of God's mercy and justice is made known to us. But who knows how long? The Lord has given us everything we need to keep the vigil all through our lives. So we should stock well our lamps and press on with fidelity. That way, we can be like the wise virgins.
Please stand.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him and all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified,
who has spoken through the prophets.
I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, let us make our needs known to God so we can prepare well for Christ's coming to us.
That all members of the church always stay awake and be ready for the return of Christ in glory, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Pope Francis, Archbishop Blair, all the priests, deacons, and religious may ignite the passion that dwells within the faith of all believers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That people from all nations be wise in seeking God and coming to salvation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That we may model the compassion of Christ and accept the responsibility to work for the eradication of hunger, homelessness, and disease, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That all of us here at Sacred Heart actively await Christ's coming by serving Christ in each other, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who serve our country, those who have died, especially Tom Sala, and those who suffer in any type of pain, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those we pray for this weekend, especially the repose of the soul of Frank Fowler, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the intentions written in our book and those in our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Almighty God, your divine Son will return at the end of time in the fullness of his glory. Be with us during our time of waiting for his return and keep us ready and alert to be received into his glory. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For your goodness we have received the bread we have for you. Food of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For your goodness we have received the wine we are for you, food of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Thank you. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice into your hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all of this holy church.
Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, upon the sacrificial gifts offered here, that, celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with loving devotion through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, an eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the jaws of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation. He works for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have helped us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, together with Francis, our Pope, and Leonard Blair, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and especially today, Frank Fowler, and all who have died in your mercy. We pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed St. Joseph, her spouse, and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. For him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of our Lord.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
May each other a sign of peace. Behold, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
We give you thanks and beseech your mercy, that by the pouring forth of your Spirit, the grace of integrity may endure in those your heavenly power has anchored. Through Christ, Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in the battle. Be our protection against wickedness and the snares of the devil. May God reboot him with humble prayer, and do your prayers for the heavenly host. By the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all of the evil spirits who wander throughout the world seeking the ruin of souls.